got a big tumor. I'm gonna have her put down.
What's that?
Got tails on them. That one comes with a bag of bags. Let's go find some more things. Vintage. How you doing? Hey, if you don't mind. Beautiful day out here.
Yeah, it's a beautiful day out here.
I appreciate the help.
$1?
Yeah, I get up in there. Have a good day. Something in a box over there. Couldn't tell what it was. Looks like plastic though. Anyway, okay. Oops, all steering wheel. We might be able to find some stuff today. I'm just really bummed out, you know, because the little black dog was my dog, you know. You guys thought the big red hound dog was my dog. I mean, they're all my dogs, but like the little white one, she sleeps with the littlest guy, the littlest of the littlest. That's kind of his dog. The brown dog, the small brown dog, that was his dog. Like when he was little, he had one of them jumper saucer swinging things or whatever. And she would sit there and lay underneath him and he'd let him like stand on him and bounce all over. They were the best of buddies. And then now that he's just a little bit older, I mean, he's still the littlest guy, but he's getting older. Anyway, the white dog, she sleeps with him, and then the brown dog sleeps under his bed. So I guess technically if she still sleeps with him, she's just like the big brown monster under the bed or something. Anyway, she's got one of them doggy beds under there, and when we pull it out, sometimes we'll find like a snack wrapper or something, or a dum-dum wrapper, you know, where she's gotten a hold of something and like guarded on it and stuff. Anyway, and then the youngest daughter, she's confiscated the two big dogs. They both sleep in her room and they stay with her. So the big brown dog, she will come out and sit on the couch with me, but she just kind of like, if you look at her every once in a while, she's just staring down the hallway like wanting back in her bedroom. So They got my dogs. They didn't get my dogs, but they got my dogs. I don't know. My personal immigrants got my dogs. They're eating the pets. I don't know. From what I understand, I don't know. You draw your own conclusions on that one. I'm just saying. I bet you're calling Fido in at night, aren't you? I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe you aren't. Maybe you are. Maybe you aren't. Maybe you are. Maybe you aren't. What's that? it's one of them janky metal shelves. I don't want to fool with that. That takes up more room than it's worth. It's got less worth than it rooms. So anyway, that was my little companion at night, my little lap dog. And she'd sleep, half the time she'd sleep right there on my pillow, or she liked to sleep in between my legs. Ladies. Anyway, I don't know, it's a bummer. But then again, I know she wasn't feeling the best, so. Because she was always real spunky and bouncy and stuff. And she got to where she was trying to hang out underneath of the couch. And then if and when you could coax her to come out a little bit, she couldn't get up onto the couch. So you'd have to put her on the couch. And then once you put her on the couch, she couldn't really get down off of the couch. So it was just kind of sad. So I told Miss Amy, like, hey, I think it's time. And then we got her to the vet, and they were like, well, you could do this, but it'll be over $1,000, and it wouldn't be till Monday, and there's really no guarantees with it, and yeah, and she might not even make it till Monday, but we can send you home with some medications and stuff. And it's just like, well, what is the other option? Which I knew what the other option was, but, you know, anyway. Hey, maybe if we're lucky, we'll see a turkey truck going by and a turkey will fall off and we'll be able to get us a pet turkey. Anyway, yeah, so I want a little doggy. I need a little doggy. I want another little doggy. I need a little doggy. Anyway. And I want a little messy dog, like one of the little Yorkie kind of muddy kind of things. You know, something that's kind of scroungy like that. Because they're cute. What is that? I thought it was a refrigerator. But now I think it's a smoker. Got a tail on it. So yeah, that was a fun adventure we had over the weekend. Not really, but yeah. What is that? I don't need aquarium stuff, do I? Pothole. Yeah, there's some aquarium stuff. That's another thing. I'm thinking I'm gonna get rid of a tank, maybe two. I don't know. You guys having fun yet? Suitcase look like it's older than dirt. This whole cul-de-sac has a very 70s vibe to it. But that's just my opinion. On a side note, that smoker smells great. I've seen a spider there, so I'm trying to like keep my hands away from the knot that I'm tying. Try tying a knot and not using your hands. After any kind of metal stuff. Yeah, look for metal stuff. I appreciate it. Have a good day. I want to show you guys something, all right? But we might get... We might get ourselves in trouble for this one. Look at my nuts. It's actually a nut sack. Technically, it wasn't my nut sack at first. It was another man's nut sack. Now, normally I wouldn't stop my truck for another man's nut sack. But what can I say? I know a couple of hungry squirrels. Ladies? No, I don't know. Anyway. I just don't want my nuts getting drugged all around the back of the truck. Thank you. scoop. Something. Something. Yeah, it's a little shorty. It's got some weight on it, though. Damn, that thing weighs a ton. Housekeeping is not doing their job. You're gonna have to go around me. Cause I wanna tie this puppy down. It's too heavy to have it sliding around. Thank you. Good enough. Appears to be a faucet on that thing. I don't want to take that big giant thing. We're gonna leave the rest of it. Damn wheel wells. Can't they make a pickup truck bed without wheel wells? Anyway. Well, not here, Russ. You think that'd be good? I think that'd probably be good. Must be bulk metal day in this neighborhood, huh? Anyway. Put some string on it. I had a van. Find the right piece of string here. Okay. Is that thing broken? Or no? Yes. It's broken. Plastic. Wood hide here. Blender. I don't know. Just something. Shoosh. It's a chainsaw. Thank you. say, I think it all went in there. Something. It's got a note on it. Works, but leaks. Okay. I know a guy who can fix it. He drives a big claw. Goofy spring-loaded lids. Let's get like 47 different streams. You know, that's how I do it. Well, not hair rust. Still got a knot here, Russ. What do you think? One more? I mean, we got a washing machine just sitting on the tailgate. Eventually, we're going to put it across the interstate. We can't get to that one, can we? Maybe. There we go. I believe that to be sufficient. You know, if a feller had one of them little buggies? Tell you what though, I'd get 14 buggies for one little dog bag. Well, let's see. I'm glad you put it out.
Yes, it got
kind of full today there.
Yeah, see that metal
shelf thing?
I don't know if you're going to have room for that.
Yes, I can fit what I can now. I'm going to try to come back around this evening, but...
Tonight?
Yeah. Yes, if I got time.
It'll be right there, and...
Up front.
What do you think about filing cabinets?
Yeah, any kind of metal.
So, there's that rack, and then, let me show you, if you do come back around.
Okay.
There's filing cabinet right here.
Okay.
The rest of that stuff, the junk guys are coming tomorrow.
All right.
And I pretty much got you all the metal out here.
I appreciate it.
If you come back, those two things would go.
Sitting up there, okay. Yeah, nice weather. Got everybody put stuff out, I guess.
I was going to open the door. Please
Yeah. Have a good day. Take a big roll of aluminum. Backseat material, I guess. Nuts and bolts everywhere. Thank you. few different things. Nah, I don't know. I was gonna pop the cup off, but does it work? I don't know. Do we want to take the whole thing? I don't know. I guess if we had one of them one things, we could stand here and plug it in. And, I don't know, maybe go inside and ask them if they have a piece of carpet we could use real quick and see if it works, you know. All that good stuff. Probably don't need to tie it down, but so far I think we've tied down everything today, so let's just put a string on it. Yeah, something like that. I don't know. I just don't want it to fall off, you know. Lady. What good would Scrappity be if it fell off? Wouldn't be very good at doing my job then, would I? Anyway, something like that. What's that? Wow. What were you keeping in that one? Little baby wildebeest. It's actually heavy for its size. Not really backseat material, but that's where we put it. I mean, at this point, that thing is awfully light. Let's put a little string on it. There we go. A little bit of aluminum. You think the bouncy house is any good? It could be. You never know about these things. I suppose there's only one way to find out, you know? You're all like, what's that, Mr. Scrappy? Ordered one of those things? And I'm like, yeah, exactly. No. Let's just take it home and find out. Anyway. I haven't actually seen one of these for a few years. Let's set it up on top of this real quick. Put some string over top of that. You don't have to watch that. Shaw. Alan, we put some stuff in the wagon, and we got a stowaway. Anyway, let's blow up this bouncy house. You gotta give me about 20 minutes or 2 days, I don't know, however long it takes to untie all these strings. Anyway, so that was Wednesday. Today's Sunday, man. Anyway, is anybody watching this thing? Can you hear me now? Something like that. I don't know. Anyway. Ladies, oh look, it's got a slide. I didn't know it had a slide. It needs a little wiping off here and there, but it's a house that's bounced. It's that Little Teak's brand, but seems to hold air. I don't hear any hissing. That is, unless we picked up any snakes in that load. Snakes. Anyway, I did get a bag of nuts. Did you see that? I mean, my nutsack. It's clear, so you can see the nuts, you know, in the nutsack. He used a plastic bag. It's clear. Anyway, so I knocked this guy off here. It said it works, but it leaks. So then, I mean, it don't work, does it? It leaks. So that's kind of one of those, is it a double entendre? Is that what that means? Something like that. Little fountain guy was working it. It leaked on the backside. Speaking of leaking. Anyway, like maybe they had dragged it around. Or say, perhaps the man who picked it up put it in his wagon, dragged it around and made a hole in it. We'll never know. But anyway, it worked. Once I flexi-coated, sprayed bobbed it, and yeah, but I had it plugged in up out there, but I just didn't, I don't know, I didn't care for it, so it is what it is. This is a bouncy house, some other stuff, anyway. Right on.